In this video, we'll be adding a gloss effect to make our graphic pop out. Virtually, we'll be trying to take a flat object and give it a three-dimensional look. To create a new file, go to the File menu and select New. Type Glossy Ball in the name box. Then from the New Document profile list, select Web. Set the size to 640 by 480. Then click OK. Select the ellipse tool hidden behind the rectangle tool. And draw a circle by holding down the Shift key. With the selection tool, select the circle, then double-click on the gradient tool. Then in the gradient panel, click the gradient fill box. And from the type list, select Radial. Click below the bottom edge of the gradient slider to add a gradient stop between the center and the right edge of the gradient slider. Double-click the left gradient stop to open the color panel. In the flyout menu, select RGB. Enter RGB values 252, 228, and 33. Double-click the center gradient stop and enter RGB values 255, 147, and 30. Double-click the right gradient stop and use the flyout menu to select RGB. Then in the color panel, enter RGB values 250, 0, and 0. In the color panel, click on the color swatch. Then click the stroke box and enter RGB values 255, 255 again, and 0. Then in the control panel, widen the stroke width to 3 points. Now to add gloss to the ball, select the ellipse tool. Then on the artboard, click and drag to draw an ellipse to represent the gloss. Double-click on the gradient tool. Then in the gradient panel, click the gradient fill box. Then from the type list, select linear. Double-click the left gradient stop and enter RGB values 0, 0, and 0 again. Double-click the right gradient stop and enter RGB values 255, 255, and 255. Next, we're going to remove the center gradient stop by clicking on it, then dragging it away from the gradient slider. Back on the artboard, position the mouse point just off the small white square on the gradient annotator. And when the pointer changes to the rotation icon, drag to position it vertically. Position the mouse pointer directly over the gradient annotator to turn it into a slider. Let's move it down to the edge of the ellipse and move our screen down by holding down the spacebar and dragging the screen downward. Now let's drag the arrow end of the gradient slider to resize it to fit within the ellipse. In the control panel, click the stroke box. Select None to remove the stroke from the ellipse. Then with the selection tool, position the ellipse near the top of the ball. In the transparency panel, go to the blending mode list and select screen. Then lower the opacity level to around 48%. Then to enhance the gloss effect, we will create two white ellipses with no stroke to add glare to the gloss. Use the ellipse tool hidden under the rectangle tool to create two ovals in the upper right side of the ball. With the selection tool, select both ovals. Go to the control panel and select Fill, White. Click anywhere on the artboard to deselect the two ovals. Then select the first oval to drag it in the ball. Let's slant our oval a little bit to the right and size it down as well. Select our second oval and drag it next to our first oval. Let's size it down and rotate it to the right. Last, let's position it better. Let's deselect the oval and select the ball. Now for the finishing touch, go to the Appearance panel. Click the Add New Effect button, point to Stylize, and select Drop Shadow. In the Drop Shadow dialog box, enter 7 in the X offset and Y offset boxes, then click OK. Let's deselect and move our screen up to have a better look at what we've created.